It's a minority college or it's a like open college?
So it's a minority institution.
Yeah.
Okay. Under the Church of North India.
Okay. What are the criteria for calling a college as a minority college?
So a minority college, it must fulfill certain criteria that has been enlisted by Constitution of India.
Mm-hmm.
For instance, so it must be largely included within the domain of the minority population.
Mm-hmm.
For instance, the college must be inclusive of that. For instance, our college, St. Stephen's College, has major criteria for admission of the Christian community.
Mm-hmm.
So in that sense, it's a minority institution. And so in that sense, the admission is all, they have some sense of reservation for them.
Okay, what privileges a minority college enjoys under the Constitution of India?
Okay, so minority college enjoys privileges in form of, like I mentioned before,
mm-hmm.
In form of admissions, some reservations provided.
Mm-hmm.
So besides that, special provisions have been made for their funding. The mid-career training program for the staff,
mm-hmm.
infrastructure and financing for the institution,
mm-hmm.
another form of funding like general administrative funding,
mm-hmm.
Has been provided.
Don't you think like by calling a institution a minority college, you are depriving others the right to education in a premier college?
Sir, I do not think that one is depriving
mm-hmm.
other institutions,
mm-hmm.
but I'd like to take it with a more positive view, because I believe, sir, when we call any institution for that matter a minority institution,
mm-hmm.
sir, we are attaching greater significance
mm-hmm.
to our minority community. We are not depriving any of the community of their minority status or their majority status for that matter.
Mm-hmm.
So what we are doing is that we are attaching significance to a community that we believe,
mm-hmm.
or our constitution believes, or our government believes, is to quite an extent subjugated, or quite to an extent deprived, or quite to an extent sidelined. So I think I take it on a positive deal. I think it's a matter of interpretation and bringing it up to the level
mm-hmm.
of the general community and providing everyone a level playing field. So I think in that sense it's quite a significant initiative.
Can you mention what provisions are made for minority community in the Indian Constitution?
I don't think I can recall right now, but I have a little problem recollecting the data and the articles.
So you have your, you've done your BA from such a premium institution,
yes,
and like you must have read all these things, and like that college itself belongs to a minority community.
Right, sir.
So you must know all these things.
Sir, I understand, sir, but right now, as of now, I'm not able to recollect. I'm really sorry.
Okay, like recently this word secular was in news.
Yeah.
Okay, we are calling that India is a secular country.
Yes.
So like, how do you see this secular in the context of recent happening in recent riots in Gujarat or recent riots in UP or in other cities?
Yes, sir. Sir, how I see it doesn't, sir, how I see the issue.
How you see the issue.
How I see the issue, okay, sir. Sir, I think our secular fabric, we do proclaim a secular country.
Mm-hmm.
Our constitution proclaims
mm-hmm.
and says that.
Mm-hmm.
And I personally also believe,
mm-hmm.
and I'm personally a very secular person, so I believe that yes, our secular fabric is, yes, it is intact.
Mm-hmm.
But sir, we have also seen instances
mm-hmm.
where this secular fabric has been trespassed with. It has been quite an extent jeopardized.
Mm-hmm.
For instance, the 2002 incident we had,
mm-hmm.
and also of late, sir, we have been seeing that minority communities
mm-hmm.
have been. They are being discriminated against, and they are being subjected to violation and exploitation
mm-hmm.
on basis of rumors or on basis of right-wing agenda.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that this is quite a significant extent a violation
mm-hmm.
of what I believe. And besides me believing, I also think that it's a violation of the secular principles that our constitution believes. Because our constitution, our country is much more than that.
Mm-hmm.
It's a very inclusive and a very encompassing nation. So I think in that sense we have been violative of on some instances here and there, but otherwise the general environment has been very collaborative and very cooperative.
Aman, आप हिंदी समझ सकते हैं, बोल भी सकते हैं।
जी सर, मैं
डॉक्टर अमिता। ये बताइए कि नक्सलवाद और आतंकवाद में क्या अंतर है? नक्सलिज्म और टेररिज्म में क्या अंतर है?
Okay sir, जो नक्सलिज्म होता है, नक्सलिज्म is इंडिया में पर्टिकुलरली प्रॉब्लम ज्यादा
इंटेंस
है, इंडिया में इंटेंस
है आतंकवाद तो हर जगह
होता है। यस सर, राइट सर, आतंकवाद इज अ ग्लोबल फिनोमेनन एंड सर इन द 21st सेंचुरी सर द दो मेजर प्रॉब्लम्स जो हमारे विश्व में समय है सर, बिसाइड्स क्लाइमेट चेंज सर, टेररिज्म इज अ मेजर प्रॉब्लम सर, ऐसे नेशनलिज्म जहाँ की आप हम बात करते हैं सर, नेशनलिज्म बेसिकली इज अ पैन इंडिया फिनोमेना, जिसकी रूट्स सर सोशल डिप्रिवेशन में, जिसकी रूट्स डिस्क्रिमिनेशन में, जिसकी रूट्स पॉवर्टी में, जिसकी रूट्स सोशल एक्सक्लूजन में. और सर जहाँ तक टेररिज्म का सवाल है सर, टेररिज्म इज अ रेडिकल फिनोमेना, इट्स अ फिनोमेना एसोसिएटेड विद रेडिकलाइजेशन, इट्स एसोसिएटेड विद रिलीजन, इट्स एसोसिएटेड विद मिस इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ सर्टेन फैक्ट्स एंड फिगर्स, जो कि हमारी रिलीजियस ग्रंथों में है, उसको मिस इंटरप्रेट करना, तोड़ना, मरोड़ना और अपने अल्टीरियर एजेंडा को फुलफिल करना. सो दिस इज व्हाट टेररिज्म इज ऑल अबाउट. हालांकि नक्सलिज्म इज अ डिफरेंट इशू लाइक एज़ आई मेंशन.
तो मतलब ये केवल इंडिया की समस्या, इंडिया की प्रॉब्लम है
सर नेक्सलिज्म? यस सर, आज ऑफ नाउ हमारे कंट्री में
कोई घटना होती है जैसे इंडिया में कोई इंटरनल सिक्योरिटी के लिए, तो कैसे बाइफर्केट करेंगे कि नक्सलवादी घटना है या आतंकवादी घटना है?
सर इसमें बाइफर्केशन हम कर सकते हैं ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ रिलीजियस प्रोपेगेंडा. सर एक घटना घटती है सर, उसमें हम ये सबसे पहले हमारा काम होना चाहिए टू एनालाइज वेदर दिस इंसिडेंट सर हैज बीन रिलीजियसली मोटिवेटेड नॉट. सर फॉर इंस्टेंस अगर कहीं पे सर कोई किलिंग होती है, शूटिंग होती है सर, देन इसमें एनी एलिमेंट और छोटा सा भी टिंज रिलीजन का है सर, देन आई थिंक इसमें इसको रिलीजियस टेररिज्म कहना ज़्यादा मुनासिब होगा. एंड अगर सर वो इंसिडेंट जिसकी हम बात करें, अगर सर वो सोशल एक्सक्लूजन से जुड़ा हुआ है, सर देन आई थिंक नेशनलिज्म वुड बी मोर अप्रोप्रिएट फॉर इन दिस कंट्री.
अच्छा अमन, आपने सर डिस्ट्रिक्ट कॉलेज से पढ़ाई की है, काफी स्वर्णिम इतिहास रहा है,
राइट राइट
कॉलेज का, सिविल सर्विसेज का इफेक्टिव कही जाती थी,
राइट सर,
आप टेन आईएफएस लोग वहीं से हुआ करते थे,
सर
आपके एलुमिनाई में बड़े बड़े लोग आते होंगे.
जी सर.
तो आपने फिर सिविल सर्विसेज की जगह ये मिलिट्री, ये पुलिस फोर्स ज्वाइन करने की जो क्यों सोचा आपने, फोर्स में जाने के लिए क्यों?
जी सर, एक्चुअली सर मेरा सिविल सर्विसेज में भी इंटरेस्ट बेसिकली बिकॉज ऑफ द पुलिस है सर, मेरा ऑब्जेक्टिव टू जॉइन द पुलिस.
क्योंकि देखा जाए तो आपके पिताजी प्रिंसिपल सेक्रेटरी रहे हैं उत्तर प्रदेश के.
हाँ जी.
और आपकी हॉबी भी बड़े अमीरों के बच्चों वाली है, फिटनेस, ट्रेवलिंग, ड्राइविंग
सर,
लिसनिंग टू म्यूजिक, कंसोल गेमिंग, बताइए सर, हमारा वर्ग का एक तो हॉबी रख लेते
सर. I absolutely agree with you sir, but I like it. It's been a privilege sir.
नहीं ठीक है सर जी, आपने जहाँ पढ़ाई की उसके लिहाज से ठीक है.
जी सर.
तो फिर आपने क्यों सोचा है सर फोर्स में जाने के लिए?
सर मैं लाइक आई जस्ट मेंशन करूँ सर, मेरा सिविल सर्विस की तैयारी करने का भी पर्पस वाज टू जॉइन द इंडियन पुलिस, एंड सर पुलिसिंग हैज बीन माय वेरी इंटेंस पैशन.
तो फिर एसएससी वगैरह के लिए ट्राई करते या फिर स्टेट देते, इसमें तो फिर फंस जाएंगे आप, फंस नहीं पाएंगे
सर.
सब लोग हैं कुछ
सर, एक्चुअली जो सेंट्रल आर्मी पुलिस फोर्सेज हैं सर, दे वर्क इन वेरी क्लोज कोलैबोरेशन विद द सेंट्रल.
जंगल में वैसे ही फ्री छोड़ दिया जाए?
नहीं नहीं सर, वो नहीं होता, दैट्स नॉट व्हाट आई मीन. सर फॉर इंस्टेंस लाइक द सीआरपीएफ, इट वर्क्स इन क्लोज कोलैबोरेशन विद सेंट्रल एंड स्टेट पुलिस सर, सो मेरा पहला प्रेफरेंस भी वही सर.
अच्छा ये बताइए कि आप जो सेंट्रल से पढ़े हैं, वहाँ पे बहुत सारे एक्टिविटीज होती हैं अधिकारों की मांग के लिए, बच्चे काफी मेहनत कर रहे हैं, आपको ऐसा नहीं लग रहा है कुछ दिनों से लोकतंत्र के सामने भीड़ तंत्र की विजय होती महसूस हो रही है? जैसे जुवेनाइल जस्टिस में देख लीजिए, कुछ लोग आए और चले गए जंतर मंतर हो गए, वो जेन्युइन चीजें होना चाहिए, जैसे वन रैंक वन पेंशन जेन्युइन था, उसके लिए लोग गए, सरकार ने किया. सरकार को भी चाहिए कि बिना
मुझे ऐसा नहीं लगता सर कि वो पीछे हो गई है लोकतंत्र. सर ये जो भीड़ तंत्र की हम बात करें सर, ये भी कहीं ना कहीं एक मैनिफेस्टेशन ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी है, बट सर इसको जिस तरीके से सर प्रेजेंट की जा रही है ये चीज़ें सर, दैट आई थिंक इज अ प्रॉब्लम.
आप यूपी के हैं, बिसाहाड़ा में एक आदमी घर घुसती है भीड़,
हाँ जी,
और घस घसीट के लाती है, उसको पीट पीट के मार देती है, और आप कह रहे हैं कि वो बिल्कुल लोकतंत्र का पार्ट है?
सर नो, दैट्स नॉट व्हाट आई मीन सर, मैं कह रहा हूँ कि सर एक ये जो भीड़ तंत्र है सर, ये एक बहुत ही गलत और बहुत ही रेडिकल फिनोमेना है, जिसको डेमोक्रेसी की वेक में कि हमारा हक है प्रोट्रे करने का, और उस हक में लोग अगर इस तरीके से पोर्ट्रे करते हैं, जैसे सर हमने दादरी किलिंग्स में देखा कि सर दैट इज भीड़ तंत्र, सर दैट इज एब्सोल्युटली रॉन्ग, सो दैट इज अ वेरी रॉन्ग फेस ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी दैट इज कमिंग, आई स्ट्रॉन्गली डिटर्स है सर, इसमें एक बहुत स्ट्रॉन्ग लाइन है सर, इसमें मैं बिल्कुल बिलीव नहीं करता.
अरे ये आपका आपका पालन पोषण बुलंदशहर में हुआ है
सर, बुलंदशहर में मैं बॉर्न
पैदा हुआ
जी सर।
बताइए पश्चिमी उत्तर प्रदेश की तीन बड़ी समस्याएं बताइए
सर। अब सबसे मेजर प्रॉब्लम तो सर इज ऑन ड्रॉट,
ड्रॉट
सर पश्चिमी यूपी अपने
पश्चिम उत्तर प्रदेश की सबसे बड़ी समस्या बाढ़ है
सर। बाढ़ एक्चुअली
फ्लड है सबसे बड़ी समस्या। आप सूखा बिल्कुल उल्टा दूसरा बताइए
सर। वी हैव सर क्राइम एट द लोकल लेवल एंड सर पॉलिटिसाइजेशन
सर।
What Saint Stephen's? Saint Stephen's College? Saint Stephen's.
Sorry, sir.
Who was Saint Stephen?
So Saint Stephen.
Yeah.
So Saint Stephen's was a visionary. He was a missionary,
yeah.
And the college has been named after him. And so he was canonized by the Church of North India. Sorry, by the Pope and then by the Church of North India.
Okay. He belongs to India?
No, sir. He does not belong.
What is console gaming?
So console gaming. So console gaming is basically gaming on a dedicated, completely dedicated platform. Like a high profile system which is technologically so sound that one could initiate into this hobby.
So what are the three qualities of you as an assistant commandant?
So I believe that I have effective leadership qualities. So I have a
visibility quality.
Sorry, sir.
Give some.
So leadership quality, I think, sir, I can guide my men if given an opportunity in a difficult circumstance. I can impose within them a strong ethical value system, code of conduct, and I'll motivate them, I'll encourage them in difficult circumstances to follow what is right.
And three weaknesses, what do you want to improve on yourself?
So my first weakness that I believe is that I often tend to get a little impulsive. And impulsive mein sir, secondly I am a little emotional also, sometimes I tend to get emotional. And so finally I believe that sir, I don't know if it's my weakness or not sir, but sometimes I tend to get influenced by somebody's emotions, by somebody's attitude towards me. And it goes both ways, on a both positive and negative manner.
What is Golden Crescent route?
So the Golden Crescent route is a very strategic area where which has become a hub of money laundering, a hub of terrorism, terrorist financing, and so that has become a very strategically challenging area as far as India's
geographical location.
Sir, it goes it touches the northernmost section of India, passing through from this Afghanistan, Pakistan, then India, entering into Uyghur region of China. So in that sense.
And Golden Triangle?
So Golden Triangle, sir, I'm not able to recollect on Golden Triangle.
Okay. Have you heard of the Parliament Security Force?
Parliamentary Security Force?
There is three layer of Parliamentary Security.
Sir, I have heard about it, but I'm not very much sure on this issue because I'm just a very, very cursory knowledge on this, not very much substantial information.
How do you see the recent attack on Pathankot on the Indo-Pak confidence building measures?
So this recent attack on Pathankot will have immense potential to jeopardize all the efforts that our Prime Minister has been undertaking in the Heart of Asia conference that we saw,
mm-hmm.
and the NSA's involvement and the discussion. So this Pathankot, this attack,
mm-hmm.
sir, I think it's like I said, it's a jeopardy. It can wreak jeopardy on our relationships. So because after the recent drop down of our Prime Minister in Lahore,
mm-hmm.
sir, the global community has been looking at India, Pakistan as a visit with a very close watch.
Mm-hmm.
And sir, even the Indian community is seeing this whole issue as a great cooperative and a great collaborative initiative. But sir, this recent Pathankot bombing that we've seen, sir, attack that we've seen, sir, and that on a very strategic area,
mm-hmm.
sir, that can be very sensitive in building a future relationship, sir, because it presents an ironical picture. On one side we are building up a good relationship with Pakistan, on the other side such kind of incidences are taking place. So I think it's a very sensitive.
So in your view, like, what should be the next course of action for the Indian government?
Sir, the first course of action in this context must be to pursue the issue diplomatically, because we have just our leaders have been diplomatically very active on this front. So if we take a very radical and a very U-turn approach on this matter, I do not think that will be very feasible. So because India and Pakistan right now, as of now, they are on a very good and the same page, diplomatically, militarily, strategically. So the first issue would be to addressing this thing diplomatically. And I believe that our diplomatic potentials are immense, and we'll be in a very good position to solve these crises diplomatically. And just in case our diplomacy does not attain the fruits that we want to see, so we can always take this issue on the international front, and on the UN platform, we can involve the Western governments, and then we can amicably solve the problem.
And you mean to say that like we should go to the United Nations and to take this issue?
Sir, not immediately. Mm-hmm. But sir, this issue will always be better, mm-hmm. rather than chasing this issue in a military manner. I think if we can resolve this issue.
But Indian government is always hesitant to take it to the United Nations.
Right, sir, because the Indian government believes that this is a violation of our sovereignty.
Mm-hmm.
But sir, rather than involving our militaries into this.
We never said that we will involve our military.
So just in case the issue snowballs,
mm-hmm.
so it is a prohibitive measure that I'm suggesting. We can always take this route rather than involving anything that can jeopardize the future relations and peace and stability in the region.
Okay, like if I will ask you, like if you have to comment on the role of United Nations.
Okay.
Like if I will say that United Nations is a police officer without having the power of lodging an FIR,
yeah.
What do you say?
Sir, to some extent I would agree with you,
mm-hmm.
because in fact to quite an extent I'll agree with you.
Mm-hmm.
Sir, because this police officer that you just called the UN,
mm-hmm.
sir, to quite an extent you're right, because we have seen that various issues that UN is involved with,
mm-hmm.
it is working in very close cooperation with its Western allies.
Mm-hmm.
So wherever we see global conflicts, both humanitarian and social,
mm-hmm.
so we'll have a footprint of United Nations. And its funding partners that we have seen the Western allies. So UN does not, I do not think it gets too much into the nitty gritty and nuts and bolts of the issue.
Mm-hmm.
And it tries to get involved in it. And various nations are complaining in this context that the sovereignty is getting violated, India being one of them.
Mm-hmm.
So in this extent, I agree with it.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you so much.